Thank you, Chairwoman Velazquez, Mr. Shabbat, distinguished members of the committee. Thank you for inviting me today to discuss Medicare physician payment. Continued improvement in quality and access of health care for Medicare beneficiaries and all Americans requires the active participation of physicians. And in order to ensure that participation, Medicare needs to appropriately compensate physicians for the services they provide to people with Medicare. But how we pay also matters. We need a payment system that will support high-quality care and avoid preventable costs to the program and to society. Simply adding expensive payment updates to the current system would be extremely expensive from a financing standpoint and would not promote better quality or more efficient care. The current system has the effect of directing more resources to care that is not of the highest quality, such as duplicative tests and services or hospital readmissions, and it doesn't do as good a job as possible in treating those with chronic conditions. That's why payment reform is also so critical for Medicare beneficiaries, who are impacted in several ways. Not only are they impacted by access issues, but they also are threatened by rapid growth and expenditures that could make services unaffordable. Growing physician costs directly impact Medicare beneficiaries through increased Part B premiums, coinsurance, and premiums for supplemental coverage. The current Medicare Part B premium stands at $96.40 per month. MedPAC recently noted over the 1999 through 2010 period, Part B premium average of 5%, while increases security benefits just 2% per year. Since 2002, the Part B premium has increased even faster by 13.4% in 2004, 17.4% in 2005, 13.2% in 2006, and 5.6% in 2007. Right now, 29% of an individual's Social Security check is applied to pay Medicare premiums, coinsurance, and deductibles. The recent Medicare Trustees Report notes that the Medicare Part A Trust Fund will be insolvent by 2019. That's 11 years from now. That means if you're 54 years old today, the Trust Fund will be insolvent the day you're eligible for Medicare. For Medicare Part B, the trustees noted that annual spending growth rate of 9.6% for the past 5 years per year. This kind of course and uncertainty for Medicare beneficiaries and physicians is why CMS has been working with Congress and the physician community over the past several years to provide a better way to pay a physician. Our work centers around new concepts in the area of value-based purchasing, with the goal of transforming CMS from its current role of a passive payer of services into an active purchaser of high-quality, efficient care. Nobody disputes the fact that there are problems with the current statutory formula for calculating annual physician payment updates. To date, we have seen short-term fixes instead of a comprehensive strategy for long-term reform. The problem with this approach is that it runs up the tab and makes the next scheduled cut even larger. Case in point, as people have noted already, this July, the law requires doctors' fees to be cut by 10.6%. Physicians face another 5% cut on January 1, 2009, and every year thereafter for the next decade. We at CMS are very concerned by this tremendous uncertainty, and this Band-Aid approach causes in terms of physician-level participation in the program, particularly for the small practices, as the chairwoman noted. In order to move forward with physician payment reform, we have embarked on the following initiatives. First, we're addressing the inappropriate payment rates for certain individual services in the physician setting. In 2006, we completed the third five-year review of physician payments. This resulted in a major rebalancing that provided for higher payments to primary care physicians. Second, we are looking at creating larger bundles of payment for care across the entire episode of care. We and others believe this holds real promise for higher quality, particularly in the area of hospital readmissions and greater efficiencies. Third, we have a shared savings demonstration that rewards physician practices for achieving higher quality outcomes and savings. The demonstration is showing already impressive results. And we will be launching soon new electronic health record and medical home demonstrations. Fourth, we're looking at better ways to measure physician resource use, with actual reports being issued to physicians how they compare with similar physicians in terms of their resource use. And then finally, we have the Physician Quality Reporting Initiative up and running. Physicians are beginning to report on evidence-based quality measures, and the first payments under the system will be made to physicians this summer. The program is an important building block towards value purchasing system for physicians. To be sure, none of the steps that I and others will be presenting today represent the proverbial silver bullet everyone is looking for to address physician payment reform. If this was easy, it certainly would have been done long ago. While many of these issues are technically complex, they represent the best thinking we and others have at this time. And importantly, there is a growing consensus among all stakeholders that they're the right direction for the Medicare program. So thank you again for the opportunity to testify on Medicare physician payments. CMS appreciates this committee's review of this issue, and we look forward to continuing to work with you and on this very important issue.